Dear friends, welcome to another Arduino tutorial. Today we are going to take a first look at the impressive Arduino 101 board. It is the first Arduino board that uses an Intel processor. The board offers some amazing features, like a dual-core processor and a hardware neural network for artificial intelligence applications. Without any further delay, let's get started. Hello guys, I am Nick and welcome to Educates TV, a channel that is all about do-it-yourself electronics projects. In this channel, I share everything about the projects I build to help you build a similar project or inspire you to start building things because it is easy, fun and creative. Subscribe to the channel now if you don't want to miss any future video. Today I'm very excited because we are going to play with this new board, the Arduino 101. This board was announced 2 years ago. It was released last year, but I just received one. It was designed to be the successor of the Arduino Uno. At first, I was not impressed by the specs of the board and I hesitated to order one. But when a company like Intel enters the maker community, their offering must be unique. So I decided to try it, mostly interested in its Bluetooth connectivity. Only when the board arrived, I discovered that inside the Intel Curie chip, there is also a hardware neural network that we can use in our projects. Yes, that's right, we can develop artificial intelligence programs with this board. I really don't know why Intel or Arduino do not advertise this feature at all. The board costs around $30 and gearbest.com website was kind enough to send me a sample unit to test it. You can find a link for the board in the description of the video below. At first, let's take a look at the board. As you can see, the layout of the board is exactly the same with the layout of the Arduino Uno board. The chip uses 3.3V logic levels, but it is 5V tolerant. On the board, we can see the Intel Curie chip, the Bluetooth antenna, some logic level shifting chips, and a flash memory chip. The Intel Curie chip is really interesting. I have created a simple table in order to be easier to see the most important features of this chip. It was developed by Intel for low-power wearable devices. There are two processors inside this chip, both clocked at 32 MHz. There is an ARC RISC processor and an x86 Quark processor. Both processors operate simultaneously. The ARC core executes the programs we develop and communicates with the x86 core that takes care of the Bluetooth low energy stack and USB communication. The chip also offers Bluetooth low energy connectivity, 24 kilobytes of RAM memory, 196 kilobytes of flash memory, 14 GPIO pins, SPI, I2C, UART, I2S buses, up to 6 analog to digital converters, a gyroscope, a 6-axis accelerometer, and a real-time clock. In my opinion, the most interesting feature the chip offers is the pattern matching engine. The engine contains a 128-node hardware neural network. The neural network has two modes, radial basis function and k nearest neighbors, and two distance modes, L1 or LSUP. The neural network has the following features. We can track a neuron with a 128-byte vector, we can save the knowledge in the network, and then we can load the knowledge back into the network. In other words, with the Arduino 101 board, we can easily build artificial intelligence programs. Those programs will be executed really fast because we will be using a dedicated hardware neural network. We can also feed this neural network with data from the embedded sensors of the board to train it. Amazing stuff! Science fiction becomes reality. I will prepare a detailed tutorial on how to use the neural network of the Arduino 101 because I find it fascinating. I first need to study more about neural networks and machine learning, so stay tuned. We can build something really cool with this board. Compared to an Arduino Uno, the Arduino 101 is light years ahead. The technology inside the Intel Curie chip is very advanced. As you can see, it outperforms the Arduino Uno in every field. From the specs we can see, the Arduino 101 operates at a frequency which is double than the frequency that the Arduino Uno operates. So, in theory, the Arduino 101 must be at least 2 times faster than the Arduino Uno, but is that the case? In order to find out, I prepared a simple benchmark. Both boards must calculate the pi with the same algorithm for the same number of iterations of the algorithm. I have connected a small OLED display to display the results. As you can see, the Arduino 101 needed 12.5 seconds to perform this task. The Arduino Uno, on the other hand, needed 26.2 seconds. That means the Arduino 101 is 2.1 times faster than the Arduino Uno in this example. In a future video, I will perform a benchmark with all the boards I have available right now. I expect that the ESP32 is going to be at least 5 times faster than the Arduino 101. You can download the code of this simple benchmark from a link in the description of the video. The Arduino 101, since it is supported by Intel, has a good library support. New libraries and examples are posted frequently. In order to use the board with the Arduino IDE, you need to install some files. Open the board manager and install the Arduino 101 package. After the installation is complete, you can execute some of the examples that come with the board. I have loaded the motion detect example, and as you can see, when the board detects movement, it lights up this tiny LED. With the examples provided, you can start using some of the advanced features of the board right away. Of course, the Arduino 101 board is not perfect. The biggest disadvantage of this board, in my opinion, is its price. Although I would happily spend $30 just to use the neural network, this board is not attractive as an everyday board. Also, the board lacks Wi-Fi, a very useful feature that many more inexpensive boards offer. For example, the ESP32 chip with about $7 offers 2 cores, Wi-Fi, Bluetooth and more memory. I think the price of the Arduino 101 board is the reason the board is not adopted by many makers. As a consequence of that, many popular libraries are not compatible with the Arduino 101. Most of the displays we use are not supported yet, and I don't know if they ever will. If there is not a strong community around a board, the software libraries will be limited, and that's the case with the Arduino 101. So, who is it good for? This board is great for prototyping wearable projects. It offers everything we need to build a project that will use the embedded gyroscope and accelerometer and will send the data in our cell phones wirelessly using the Bluetooth connectivity it offers. It is a great board for schools and education in general. Now that we know that the board also features a hardware neural network inside, this board is great for some simple artificial intelligence projects. That's what I'm going to test first. Who cares about Bluetooth when you can easily implement some machine learning algorithms in this chip? The AI revolution is about to start, so we'd better learn as many things as we can about it. I would love to hear your opinion about this board and about the neural network it offers. Are you going to use this board in any of your projects? Please post your comments in the comment section below and don't forget to like the video and share it with your friends if you find it interesting. Also, consider subscribing to the channel and do click that bell or YouTube might not show you updates as new videos come out. If you are going to be shopping for parts, check out the affiliate links from the video description. That's it for today guys, thank you very much for watching, I'll see you in the next video.